So whenever you leave this room, always close the door behind you.
Okay.
Yeah.
I do not like cats in here.
My hands are frozen. I was waiting at the bus stop for a while. My bus missed the cycle.
What bus did you take to get here?
9.
From where?
I don't know. But I came and then it had gone early, right?
Yeah.
So I missed, I had to wait another, 10, 20 minutes.
Is there any particular character you want me to play, or any match you want to work on, or?
Not right now, no. I just need to warm up my hands.
Cool.
Alright, just give me a second to get my hands all ready.
Yep.
shit. I jump when I don't mean to jump.
Yeah, winter sucks for melee. I don't. All I have is toilet paper.
Okay.
I Oh no. That percent, like anything above 150, a good way to get to close out the kill is just to back throw them, not to down throw them, but to back throw them, because typically they'll get launched up at a perfect spacing where you can just hit them with a forward smash and kill them. It doesn't even matter if it like tippers or anything, because they're such high percent. But typically when they exceed 150, that's when I back for them. And then I usually get killed that way.
Okay, they can
DI it, but it's a good way to catch people off guard because you don't typically back throw as much. You down throw or up throw or up throw. Back throw kind of sucks.
Yeah.
Except in that situation.
Okay. Is that a situation where I should back throw, or is it too low?
I think it's too low for a back throw, per se, but pretty much you could, if you're near the ledge, like you kind of were here, you were kind of on the left of the stage, you could probably down throw and it would send me off stage and you could try for an edge guard that way. But up throwing me doesn't really get me anything unless you, like, try to catch me as I land and hit me with a fair or something like that.
Yeah.
But I would just, in that situation, I would just go for the edge guard, like 183%. That's when I would start back throwing to try and get a force match to close it out.
Okay.
But if I'm near like the ledge or anything, I'll always try and like down throw them to throw them off ledge and go for an edge guard because I know that's more guaranteed.
Also, I think I should, when you side B, I'm going for down tilt, and then it would probably be better just jab that, right?
It depends on the height. So if you see that I'm like perfectly flush with the ledge,
then
and I'm not like above the lip or anything, you want to go for a down tilt. Or if you're feeling really fancy, actually no, never mind, that's a bad option. But no, yeah, go for a down tilt when I'm just headed straight for the ledge. If I'm trying to recover with side B on the stage, then I would go for a jab.
Thank you.
I'm trying to be, like, patient in those hyper-sense scenarios, but I think I need to be, like, not less patient, but do more things that'll kill instead.
Like, I feel like I'm just kind of running you down right now, so you're just kind of trying to dash dance through the ledge. But, like, personally for me, like, that's what I do. I kind of know, like, how to beat that just by overextended aerials. And Cito does it to me all the time, because that's the way I play against him, too. So he just runs me down, and there's nothing I can do, so I just end up dash dancing near the ledge. And all he does to beat that is just overextend his nairs, and I always get hit, and then he just gets a sick punish off of it.
Okay.
When I'm at, like, high percent like that, you can literally stick out, like, any move, and it'll put me in a bad position, whether it's, like, offstage or, like, above you. And then you just try and hit them from there. But there's no point in, like, waiting near the ledge when you're, when they're at high percents. That's something you want to do, like, when they're low percents, to go for, like, an early jump or something like that. But you might as well just make an attempt to try and hit them when they're at that high percent, because literally any move will put them in a bad position.
Okay.
And then you can, like, edge guard them or something like that.
Another problem I have is that I'll go for a punish, even though I can't actually get it.
Yeah, you're trying to reach to, like, make it work. I don't know. At that point, you gotta get used to, like, recognizing the spacing and recognizing your timings. Like, for a Ken combo, because you go for a lot of those. Like, there's a very, very particular, very obvious angle that, like, you'll look at it and you'll see, yeah, that's, like, a Ken combo for free right there. Like, see, like, I knew the spacing was bad on that, I went for it anyway.
Uh-huh.
It's just something you get used to with time.
Yeah, I do it a lot less now, but I still do it.
Just know that it's better, even if you don't get the punish, like, it's better to not put yourself in that kind of position, because when you, like, when you go for the down air, you kind of put yourself in an overextended position off stage, and then it's easy for me to, like, capitalize on that. But, like, it's better to not get that punish than it is just to put yourself in a bad position. Because you can just go ahead and get another punish.
Yeah.
I just kind of read that you were going to land there.
Yeah.
Better to try and to put them above you, to up throw them rather than forward throw them, because you can, like, forward throw them and get, like, a forward smash, and then maybe it'll hit. But if you're against, like, anyone decent, like, you know, Mastodon, like me, especially Mastodon, because he's so used to DIing those forward throws, because that's how I used to beat him, just by forward throw, forward smashing him, and now he DIs him every single time. But the way he beats me now is he just basically gets an up throw on me, and then he never lets me down, and I just die.
Okay.
Yeah, kind of, because there's ways to beat, if you're just like short hopping like that, and I just catch you with like a dash attack or something like that, it's kind of shitty. But if you just want to, if you want to cover yourself while you do a short hop, just like try and stick out like a really late aerial as soon as you see them trying to go in on you. You don't, it's not necessarily like the worst thing to do, and it depends on like the range that you're doing it at, sort of thing.
Yeah.
It also depends on like their percent, right? If they can like crouch cancel your aerial, right? Then they can just get a grab off you or something like that. Better than Lewis's, so.
Oh, I didn't mean to.
At that point, you just kind of got, like, when you're just kind of juggling them with up airs, try and go for, like, a fair to push them off stage or something like that. Like, any high percent will do. Basically, your end goal is to kind of put Falcon in an edge guard situation. That's kind of how you have to beat him.
Yeah, that's what I mean, though. Like, I don't know when is the right time to let him go into the edge guard situation.
Basically, if he's at, like, high percent, you can push him off stage. anytime you can really get him off stage, realistically. Like, if you're, like, comboing him in the middle of the stage, then you can just try and, like, carry him to the ledge or something with, like, fairs or something. Maybe after a couple up airs, you go for, like, a fair, and then you try and catch him with another fair to push him closer to the ledge.
Yeah.
And then put them in that edge guard situation. Thank you. got my hair cut yesterday and I lost so much hair off of it. Wearing this hat actually feels weird now.
I hate having my hair cut.
Careful not to hover like just outside of Mars like tipper range with like a 4B like that.
Yeah.
Because it's like it's too easy to, for me to just jump up there and hit you. People like Mastodon really prey on that too. They really scout for like your double jump and your side B, like in the Ditto.
Yeah.
Like that's specifically what he looks for.
Yeah.
Because he knows that like that basically puts Mars in the worst position.
Just grab flinch there.
Yeah. Like when you try to limit, like when you side B above the ledge and right at the ledge. You never want to side B in those locations because then I can just stick out a down tilt or any move really and hit you. And if you're above the lip, then I just jump up with a fair and now you're fucked. The places you want to side B at, like you can, if you're like, if you've like DI'd all the way up and you're trying to get back. You can side B like up there, but you have to stop side B'ing at a certain point and try to drift towards the ledge, because once you're close to the ledge and you put yourself, like stalled yourself in place with a side B, it's too reactable for them to come up and just hit you. Or like you can do what Mastodon does, and he waits until like the very last moment below the stage to use his side B till he gets like the little sort of upward boost of it, and then he uses his double jump, and then he recovers. So, like, basically all the way up there and all the way down there are, like, the places you want to use your side B.
Okay.
Or, like, if you're... It's kind of situational, but, like, if you're, like, directly above Marth or even, like, Fox or something, and you're trying to... You can just, like, use your side B to stall up there.
Yeah.
That's what I like to use it to. But, like, not near, like, the lip of the ledge and not, like, right at the ledge.
Okay.
Like, in that situation, you definitely don't want to try and land on me either, because then I can just forward smash you away. I would have tried to make it to, like, the platform or something. Maybe try and air dodge onto the platform. Or maybe just, like, drop down lower and go for the ledge.
Okay.
Basically, if you're ever in doubt as to where you're, where you want to land when you're off stage, just go to ledge. The thing I don't like about Ganondorf's aerials is it's so blatantly fucking obvious when you miss an L cancel. Makes you feel like shitter.
Yeah.
Also, when you turn around like that, I can't use down B. It happens so frequently too, you just get turned around and you're launched right off stage. And like his best recoveries is like down beat. So I can't use it when I turn around.
Yeah, then he says something there. It's hard to get something to work on and then get it right away.
Yeah, it's all habits, right? And like everyone has habits that are like really obvious. And they always take forever to break. It's just recognizing those habits, because once you start recognizing them, then you can start working on them. Again, a privilege. How do you feel about this matchup?
I've been working on it. That's the matchup I've been working on. I've been trying to play against Elgin and John while I'm working on it.
I hate this matchup so much.
Yeah.
I guess
it feels really bad sometimes.
Feels almost like Sheik wins.
Yeah, I think she wins a little bit.
I think so too. I just am thinking, in terms of sheer punish game, she wins.
Like, yeah, she gets so much.
Yeah. I think against, like, dudes like Slice, I'm gonna start Sheik doing, because I think I can beat, I think I actually beat him with my Sheik. But he's just so much, I don't know. Sheik can just cheat in so many different ways. Were you going for, like, a forward smash there?
Yeah.
I don't know if that would have hit either, but I might have tried that too.
I'm trying to just work on where I attack on the platforms, and also trying to do more down tilts too.
Down tilt is super fucking good in this matchup. Like, you just sit there and down tilt in the right areas, like, not right up in Sheik's face, but just, like, right outside of her grab range. There's literally nothing she can do. Like, if she tries to wave dash in, she can just, you can just wave dash back or down tilt again and you'll hit them. You just push them back out. Like, down tilt is super broken in the matchup.
I wanted to grab that thing.
I think Marth wins ground game, like, very, very hard, but I think in terms of, like, sheer punish, Sheik wins. Sheik just out-punches Marth so hard.
Yeah.
With Marth, you actually have to read their DI and you actually have to scout for a grab, and it's always really risky because you risk being grabbed yourself and then you just get punched even harder.
I always up smash when I mean to
forward smash?
No, up tilt.
Up tilt?
Like, she punishes you so hard if you try to go for a grab.
Yeah. Like, if you get a grab, it's great. And maybe you'll get something off of it. But if she gets a grab, she's probably going to kill you. It's like high risk,
yeah.
Medium reward sort of thing. And, like, people just say, like, oh, well, just DI, like, her forward tilts and her throws and shit. But then you get put into, like, another tech chase situation. And it's so easy for her to just react to it, too. And, like, no matter what, you're just put into, like, a really bad situation.
Uh-huh.
Jeez. It's just so easy. Like, it's like, I like the Marth Ditto because no matter how
you can just do that.
Yeah, you can just do that and then you're back. But it's like, no matter how, like, I could be up 3 stocks on you and it really doesn't matter. Like, all it takes is, like, bad DI on, like, a forward throw forward smash or, like, something like that, and then a quick easy edge guard. Like, you can just, Marth just gaze himself in so many ways, and he combos himself really hard too. Like, it really doesn't matter. It's, like, one of those matchups where you can always come back. See, and just like that, it's even.
Yeah.
Yeah, your movement's, like, it's really important, but I don't know where I was going with that thought. There is something about your movement, though, like...
Because I'm staying at the edge, and I'm not, like, going in. I should stay and try to take center more.
Exactly. And, like, in the ditto, like... Standing at the ledge and just, like, waiting for them to approach you is good if, A, they're spacey, and B, they don't really know how to, like, approach you, and they just kind of just get gimped over and over again.
But you can't really, like, down tilt at the ledge in mark dittos.
No.
Because that's really dangerous.
Even, like, but Marth can't really, it's also that Marth can't really gimp himself the way that he can gimp spaceys. I feel like in the Marth ditto, it's more combo-oriented and, like, DI dependent than just like a really gimpy sort of edge guardy kind of matchup. Like you can't really do that, honestly. So many people don't know about that.
He faces down. I hate Pokemon Stadium. It's so glitchy and there's so many stalemates.
It's just, it can change the tie so bad. Like, how many times have you ever been in like that last stock situation on fucking Pokemon Stadium where the stage is all fucking weird and you're all panicky and it just fucks up your movement and stuff like that? Like, so many times.
Like, I'm okay
know.
With the grass one and the, kind of the windmill one, but also the windmill's kind of stupid, too.
Yeah. I hate rock transformation. I think
rock is awful.
Yeah. Kind of went bad where you couldn't really get a follow-up off of it.
Nice. I should have gone more there. I meant to do like an upper, but then I realized I like misspaced it. So then I figured, oh, I'll just do it back here.
Yeah, there are so many times where like, there's so many times where it's like, oh, all I can really get here is a back air, but I can't get anything else off of it. I'm like, I know what that's like. Yeah. Oh, that was weird. Situation, you just want to counter.
Okay.
Pretty much, if I'm up being like from below the lip of the stage, you want to counter. The only way that they can get around that is if they sweet spot perfectly, which is really difficult, or if they just go straight up and try to land towards the ledge. But if they do that, you could probably just react with the forward smash. I'm just gonna go to the washroom real quick.
Okay. Thank you.
I'd say in regards to your question about the short hop, if there were a matchup where I wasn't going to do that in it would be this one. Because I can just hit you with, like, you know, just like that.
Yeah.
Like that, and then I just hit you. So I would... It's actually, like, very key in this matchup that you stay grounded. Because both these characters kind of lose the matchup the same way. If you approach from the air as Mark, you're going to lose. If you approach from the air as Sheik, you're definitely going to lose. You gotta stay grounded, and you gotta focus more on your... It's like a matchup of discipline. You gotta focus more on your down tilts and your grabs. Like, you can't really bully Sheik with aerials, because she can just... You can jump at her, and then she'll just F-tilt you, and then you're dead.
Oh.
Wow, there was a bop there.
There's times when I think, oh, I can just,
Nope.
I can just go in because she's teching right with an aerial, but you can't.
She's too good at this.
What frame does her Nair come out on?
What frame?
Yeah.
I'm not sure on the frame data. I've never been like a frame data kind of person.
Okay.
All I know is it's really fast.
Yeah, I know that.
That's something that, like, Derek would probably be able to answer.
Okay. Oh.
I was expecting a forward smash there.
Wish I got the down.
God.
I was worried you were gonna make it back.
Yeah, I thought it was too. Stay grounded. It's so easy.
Thank you. like, my neutral is really on and off. Like, sometimes I feel like my neutral is really good, and it like, there's a really big spectrum for it.
I say if you want to, like, focus more on your neutral, you gotta spend as little time doing moves as possible. So, your main tools in neutral are, like, your dash dance and your down tilt, right?
Yeah.
And stuff like that. So, one thing you can work on as well, like, if down tilt is, like, your primary, like, approaching move, your primary neutral tool, is get down the ASI frames, the, you know, interruptible as soon as possible frames. You have 20XX, right?
Yeah,
so you can just work on that in 20XX. Particularly in this matchup, too, because dash dance and down tilt and, you know, grab are, like, your biggest assets in this matchup.
Okay.
Other than that, it's just getting a feel for, like, the spacing and, like, knowing when they can hit you, when you can hit them, when they can hit you, but you can't hit them, and vice versa, stuff like that. Like there could be a weird situation where that would hit.
Yeah.
That's sick. That's not what you're doing.
I knew it. I wanted to go on Randall, but I didn't mean to edge cancel it.
Oh no.
Stupid character.
You know, right?
Thank you. test something.
Sure, what's up?
I wanna work on just go on the ledge and I'm gonna see what I can do to like go in and like threaten the Shino stall.
Oh, you want me to Shino stall?
Yeah.
Fuck. I'm also not very great at Shino stall. Fucking random.
Yeah, I think I have an idea of like what I can do.
Yeah, you're like trying to snipe the ledge from them. There are certain ways you can do that, like. Like I've done that to like slice before.
What's like the timing? Like when should you start the wave dash?
When should you start it?
Yeah. Like as soon as she goes off of the ledge.
I say as soon as she starts, if you're gonna try and like grab the ledge from her. Not necessarily with just like a wave dash, but like with anything, right? Because you don't want it to be too telegraphed. Because a lot of good sheiks will know that, like, hey, he's gonna try and grab the ledge from me while she is stalling. But like when they jump off the ledge and they get ready to do their up B, like as soon as they disappear, that's probably when you want to do it. Because any time before that, they can probably just go on like stage ringing and then you're on ledge now.
Yeah. Okay.
Did you still want to play against Sheik, or...?
I'll play against Smart.
Yeah.
And, like, what should I do in neutral against Smart?
Against Smart? A lot of the same shit with Sheik, actually. Like, a lot of, just down tilt. Good down tilt usage will just get you, like, a bunch of free grabs. So, I just down tilt, and then I come out with a grab, and then I can...
Okay.
Do whatever I want. Basically... That's how neutral is. I think it's. I feel like it's more punish oriented, especially in this matchup. But in terms of just sheer neutral, like you wanna use a lot of down tilt, and just the way it hits Marth, it'll usually set them up for like a free grab, unless they DI it or unless they're at like high percent. I don't know why I did that.
Oh, I was close to getting this there. Not getting on it, but like getting on the stage.
It's pretty much like this matchup is just how you follow up on your grabs. Oh, nice.
Thank you.
You could have got it if you got the L cancel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. I would be fine with the Marth matchup if I didn't get all my stuff stopped by, like, Bears so much.
Yeah, it kind of works both ways, though. You just kind of got to recognize the timing and the spacing for when you can stick at loose interrupt. But, of course, there are a bunch of different ways you can try and bait that, right? You can, like, try and pull back mid-combo to get them to, like, throw out a move, and then you just keep comboing them. Maybe you fish out a move or, like, another jump.
I think I'm also, like, following up a lot slower than I could be, right? Like, I could follow up a lot faster than I do.
When it comes to, like, following up and knowing what to do to follow up and stuff like that, like, watching videos of people playing is extremely good. Like, my edgeguarding got fucking phenomenal, and it's, like, the thing I'm most known for, because, like, I spent, for an entire month, I watched, like, 749 UGKing edgeguards with Martin. I watched that for like a month straight when I was working overnight shift at work, and now my edge guards are like fucking amazing on the bases.
Pivot grab more like a neutral.
Yeah, I saw that. That's it.
And then I think after this game, I'll play Falco.
Falco?
Fear of Impact.
Sure.
Yeah. Or, like, if you can play Falco.
Yeah, I can play Falco.
Okay.
That kind of situation, you just want to forward throw me off the ledge and go for a down throw.
Okay.
Because of it or something?
I was gonna win a set against Arrogate Commander. Like, I was doing a falling, I was falling down, and I was gonna do an up air right.
Yeah.
I was at the perfect percent where I would have gotten, like, a forward smash too, and it fanned. And
oh,
then
no.
He punished me because of that, and then I lost off of that. I didn't have a problem with fan hits until then.
Yeah, that can happen sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
down for that too, to be honest.
It's, I love getting the reverse on the down air. It feels so nice.
In that situation, I would have either forward tilted or forward smashed.
Okay.
If you're feeling really ballsy, you can go for a forward tilt. Forward smash maybe should work.
Okay.
Play on FD. Last forever.
With that green overlay on top of your character,
yeah.
Sometimes I lose track of where my character is. Cause I'm playing Green Falco, and you're playing it.
But it's dark green. I'm also wearing a tag.
Yeah, but like when you shine me, it gets really confusing.
Does it? Okay, I'll turn the overlay off. I think it's handy. It's like, you know what that overlay is, right?
I actually don't know, sorry.
Basically, whenever your idol is just staying there, it glows green. So, the idea is you want to keep moving, right? So, the less time you spend in the green like that, it's the better.
Oh, okay.
Whoever gets the first laser gets like usually a super sick punch.
Lasers.
Yeah. That was good DIY on the fair, though.
Oh, yeah. I don't DIY enough stuff.
Thank you.
hands are still cold.
They're still cold?
I was playing solitaire at the bus stop. I shouldn't have done that. I should have kept my hands in my pockets. That's my job.
Just gotta invest in some hand warmers, man. Luckily, I never go outside, so my hands don't get cold.
Probably like two more, and then I should head out.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
After this, you just want to play best of five?
Sure, yeah.
How far away do you live?
I live in Byron, so I don't know, it's probably like half an hour on the bus.
Yeah. Well, it's only one bus though, right? Isn't it? Isn't it like the 17 or
there's
something?
There's like, yeah, but I think you kind of have to take two buses or else it's a bit of a walk.
Oh, okay. So I remember I had a job interview in Byron and I only had to take one bus to get there. I got the LK in front of me, I could follow that. Alright, we'll play best of five. You can strike first.
Okay. Let's strike. Dreamland and Fountain.
No, you gotta strike once.
Oh.
There.
Sorry.
That's okay. Strike. Dreamland. Fuck that stage. I don't wanna hear what she's in the market. I'm gonna switch characters, okay?
Okay. I can go.
You can go on any stage you want.
Oh, okay.
You wanna go back?
Yeah.
Alright. Joke's on you, I actually love this guy. I should have fun FT.
Yeah, I shouldn't double jump there. I didn't need to wave land there. So I was like, what do I do now?
So yeah, it'll be on my Twitch. I always upload every sesh to my YouTube channel too, so. Yeah, it's a good 2 hours of footage. Some of me talking, so. Should be useful for practice, I think.
I don't think I played like my best today. But I'll work on some of that stuff.
Well yeah, just like work on the stuff you weren't feeling too hot on and any clarification on anything. I was talking a fair bit, so
yeah. Thanks.
It's just about habits and stuff, so you can just remind you. Stop double jumping around the lip or whatever, or random stuff about Fox or whatever.
Okay.
It's informative.
Right here the minute you try and leave. Yeah.